now. Thank you for joining us and welcome, sports fans. You are now watching the Baseball Hippy Show, Baseball Hippy Show, Baseball, Baseball Hippy Show. Wow, wow, it's the Baseball Hippy Show. Welcome all, it's just love and baseball. Just love and baseball. Just love and baseball. Baseball Hippy Show, welcome all, it's just love and baseball. Baseball, baseball, baseball Hippy Show, welcome all, it's just love and baseball. Baseball, baseball, just love and baseball.
Welcome, 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 welcome.
Baseball.
Yeah.
Thizzle. Mr. Thizzle himself, man. That's pretty funny. Shout out to Mac Dre. Preemptive shout out this week, this week, this year, this season. We're back, everybody. Baseball Hippy Show. Season 5. F1. It's been a long hiatus. The Baseball Hippy Awards were called off in season 4. Life got in the way. Brown Bear's off paternal leave. Tobe went to spring training. Otani's got 500K on that Baltimore game. So it's good they picked up Webb. It's good they picked up Webb, everybody. Nah, but a lot of change, a lot of stayed the same, man. It's just good to be back talking baseball with you fellas. So as we do every show, as we started off, Brown Bear, engineer extraordinaire, how is it going, man? Running the show. He's got the live operation on right now.
It's good, man. Going good. Glad we're back at it. Glad baseball's back. It's the best time of year.
Yeah. Tobe, co-host, oh, yeah. Social media manager, all of the above. How's it going, my little Brady Bunch square?
What's up, boys? Good to see you, man. Good to see you. Good to be back. It's been a tumultuous off season, as they are, but you know, we're back. We're back. We're lively. We're hyped. And it's good to see you guys, man.
Hell yeah.
Hell yeah, man. You look like you got a tan, man. You been down in... Been
yeah,
down
man, in, you know...
Peoria.
I actually was hanging out with the owner of the Fanatics. I was on that yacht boat all-white party. Muffet. Everybody's hating on the Fanatics jerseys training. This year, but he's a good guy, man. He's a good guy.
Did this all happen in Peoria, Arizona?
Yeah, little do they know, they actually... You know, in some real estate in Peoria. It was me, Meek Mill. Never mind. Never mind. Yeah, it's going to be back, man. Got a little tan in Peoria. I might have been in spring training. Social media manager. I had to, you know, we had to meet some people down there. I was trying to get in. With the social media account at the Mariners, and didn't get anywhere close. Okay.
Well, it's good to be back talking baseball with you guys. Yeah, man. New season, new stories, and definitely there's going to be some new moments made this season, like every season. Last year was grimy, dude. Basically, when Tim Anderson got knocked out on a baseball field, it was just really big, just kind of changed. But you knew what year we were going into, and already the Otani scandal is like sets the stage, or if that's what you could call it. It kind of depends on who you ask. But man, before we get into all that, give our shout outs this week. And we're going to shout out Ryan Stanek down there at the bottom right or left, depending on where you are, I guess. Yeah, so he just looks super chill in this Mariners like photo. Like, can you get that to the front anyway, or is it hard? Is it that's so?
Let me get it up there.
It's kind of like our fourth.
I just saw this on the Instagram.
There you go.
They were just rapping. I mean, that's a blurred picture, but it's just like him chilling on the side of the subway, or like buying some smokes, waiting for his friend to buy beer, just enjoying some sunshine, I guess.
Sell you a dub sack behind the middle school.
He does got
Look,
that
there's
solo
a
job. He's
there's
got
a two thousand there's a couple 2017 Jets pictures that look mighty familiar to that look right there, dude. I'll say that. Almost to the T, dude. With the beanie in there. You have to pull those back check down.
He's not lying, everybody. He's not lying. So, anyways, this is like early, definitely early submission for the fucking baseball hippie award. We should just give it to him now, really, if you ask me, because you're right. From like 2000, yeah, he does look like me. Someday I'll look like that again. I bet you.
That shirt's
Someday's
hella
I.
funny to me because it's got nothing to do with baseball.
Yeah, that's
It
crazy.
looks like a
Yeah.
skier.
It is a
Yeah.
skier.
He's got the beanie. Perfect. It's perfect, man.
Yeah, that's
He looks
crazy.
like a
That's
fan
the.
and a player at the same
I could see it if they did like a if they did like a holiday sweater Mariner, like a Mariner's holiday sweater, throw a skier on there, but
Ugly
like a short sleeve t-shirt with a skier on it and just some slap a Mariners logo on there. Like,
that's crazy, dude. That's the
that's somewhat funny
they
as hell.
say they got some kid out of college with the little graphics,
Man,
online
they're
graphics art degree.
Yeah, no, I'm telling you, dude, they have every demographic covered in their store. I saw a patch that looked like a cassette tape, and then it said Mariners on it. I have it on my Instagram somewhere. Just like, what? They think of wild shit. So, shout out, man. Shout out to Ryan Stanek. And
Patrol.
yeah,
Speed
shit, so much
Patrol.
to talk about. So much to talk about. Where do y'all want to start? Because before Ohtani, the jerseys were a big scandal, but that doesn't seem like. See, I've been
I think they look like
consumed. Yeah.
fucking trash. I feel like I can tell the difference, and they the uniforms this year look like trash.
See, I watch on the
Yeah, they're god
projector,
awful.
so
They're
it's
god
like
awful, bro.
I haven't been able to see yet. I watch on my computer sometimes, but.
I feel like they're like
They got them.
impossible to iron out, so they all look wrinkly as hell.
Okay.
Yeah, they got them at I touched some of them. It's crazy when you like actually see them at the store. You can, it's like not even an argument. It's crazy. It just feels like a replica jersey, and they're selling them for 300 some places. So it's like, and
That's
the Mariners,
crazy.
actually, I didn't know this. I thought all of them changed to iron on, but actually the Mariners are only a couple of the teams that they changed to iron on, and some of the teams still have stitching on it, which is bizarre. But shout out that YouTube channel, Baseball Doesn't Exist. They just ran this crazy thing about the Fanatics this week, and it's an interesting watch. Yeah.
I heard that Fanatics couldn't even fill the orders, though, is what's going on with that. It's like they're
Yeah.
way behind on production, so only certain teams have the new jerseys, and most teams only have their main jersey in the new design. Like, it seems whack.
Yes,
Like,
some of
that's
the
why last
Padres.
Sunday they didn't wear their Sunday jerseys, because they don't have the new Sunday jerseys yet.
Damn, that's crazy. Yeah, last the pot some of the Padres are wearing their old pants because you can't tailor the new ones. And then there's the famous, or there's the funny story from this offseason or spring training. There's a Mariners minor leaguer who got retweeted. He posted his jersey, he got retweeted because all the lettering was all fucked up. And the Fanatics added them, were like, wow, looks like we really dropped the ball on that one. We'll send you a jersey. And then it got shown that it was just an actual player worn jersey. And then they deleted the tweets. We're like, oh shit. Hide the tracks.
Yeah. You know, it feels like a freaking New York Times like podcast or something. Like it
Dude,
feels like the
it's
story is just deep, like they like you're saying, like the production and all that. Like who is the old distributor, and like why'd they back out of deal. I'm curious.
Was Majestic on baseball? See, I just watched this shit, so I don't want to go too crazy on it, but I can give people a little
you're talking
breakdown.
about
It's
baseball
mad
doesn't
interesting.
exist or did this.
Dude,
Okay, cool. I'm
yeah,
gonna watch
they ran a little 40-minute one. It just covered all the questions. Mad interesting. But
okay.
so yeah, Majestic used to do baseball. Adidas was basketball, and then I think I forget the one that was Nike, or I forget the one that was football. But Nike
Yeah.
bought each of the leagues for $1 billion for 5-year contracts, and it was like I think they said baseball for Majestic was only like a $40 million contract, and so now they're doing like 200 a mil or 200 a year. Baseball couldn't deny it, and then basically their only thing is they just want the swoosh on every single jersey, but they don't make any of the jerseys. And even like the Yankees, they're pointing out was like against their code to even put anything on it, and now they have the swoosh on it. But yeah, exactly like Brownbear said, Fanatics got too much shit, too much now, so they can't fill the holders. But the most interesting part, and this has nothing to do with baseball, they said it all tracks back to fucking Jeremy Lin and Linsanity, because when he got hot, there was no Jeremy Lin jerseys anywhere, and Fanatics at that time was the only place you could make a jersey online and get it within a couple of days. And so they made a shit ton of money, and then the next year, Adidas, or like the league got hella mad at Adidas, and then he dropped off, and then they just had like $1 million wasted a product, and then Adidas was like, we don't want to make jerseys anymore, and then Nike was like, yeah, we'll buy all these leagues and then work with Fanatics because they're on their shit and they can print out all these jerseys. But I think it's just like, you know, the quality is bad. I think they got finesse. I think in the future, I think Nike's going to drop Fanatics next year, because I think they're getting a lot of flack for this. I don't know.
They are, but also, I feel like Nike's trying to spin it like there's some like high tech, like ultra designed, like
right,
jersey.
Right,
like right. They're like, oh, the reason they fit all weird is because we made them like super athletic cut so that they like work better on the field and like fit better and have less drag right. and all this. And like, the reason the material looks so cheap is it's actually super high tech, like moisture wicking, like, you know, I don't, and like the reason we're ironing shit on and not stitching on is because it's better for the environment. That's like literally like what they're, I saw some big, like
it's crazy.
Big page layout on like why they're designed that way basically. And I think they were debuted at the Seattle All-Star game last year, but no one could tell because those jerseys are busy. Like they're like teal camo. So you couldn't really tell how shitty the material was.
Right. This is our new patented technology, the fucking shit tech.
Shit tech. They have some dumb name for it too, I swear.
Yeah. The stitching is the one that kind of pisses me off the most though. Cause it's like baseball jerseys and the stitches. Stitching names on the back is so classic.
And the pants look like shit too. They're so, it's like such thin
yeah.
material. You can see everything
dude,
that's
you
like
see the,
tucked in.
Bro, you see the balls? You see that dude's nut sacks? Yeah. That fool in the Giants, there's a picture on his like media day. You can see his nut sack, dude. It's crazy. Like full nuts just hanging down. And then they're like, no, nah, this just happens every media day, bro. Like, I don't know.
No, I didn't see that one.
Pull that up.
You should. I'm not bashing any of it, man. We're the baseball hippie show. Thanks for coming.
Honestly, I'll look it up, but I don't know if YouTube might take it down. Like, it's not that, dude. Like, I'll send it to the Discord.
I mean, if that's what you're going for, it's kind of an ill look. It's got a rave, you know, it's like rave culture vibe, but it's like baseball is interesting. I'm starting to really like, yeah, I mean, like the era is represented by the decades you play in. So it's just like the total 2000, like I'm trying to decipher what the 20s are going to be like. And baseball, I think this is part of its legacy. It's just like Nike's kind of hit this point with like, you know, the way things are in the world and,
I will
actually yeah.
feel like that, yes, but I also think you got to give them, not to like give too much props to Nike, they don't need it, but I will give them a little bit of credit that, like, between like if you put on a jersey, an MLB jersey from like 1998. Like, that shit must have sucked to, like, run in. Like, thick-ass, yeah, weird material. So I can see where they're going with, like, we need something more athletic. But these, I swear, they're, like, it seems like the free jersey you get at, like, a giveaway day. Like, yeah, that's the quality of the jersey.
For sure, dude. I just, and even watching that video, not to keep talking about it, but it's like, yeah, it's like they don't even really blame too much on Nike. It's just like, it just seemed like some, a lot of people got fired in between their quality control, some lacked. And then, of course, like you said, like they couldn't produce them all. So some, I think, corners got cut. But the biggest thing too is like they said within the past 5 years, there's been 400 different types of jerseys with all the city connects and all that shit. And just like three, you know, away, home, and like two alternatives. So I think that's where they knew that they could make, that's why they bought all this shit for $1 billion, because they're like, bro, we can sell five different jerseys now. And this, you know,
but then they said last year they like drop, they like, we won't make more than four jerseys per team. So that's why like the Mariners don't have the gray tops anymore, is because they're just like, we can't, you have to pick four jerseys that you want. You know, the whites, the navies, the teal, and the Sundays.
Teal sleeve boys.
Good God. Yeah. All right. Well, that also, we'll see where that goes. But if like jerseys are getting ripped in the playoffs and shit, people are gonna be pissed. But maybe they'll have like playoff jerseys made or something. I don't know. But man,
I sent the nutsack photo. Yeah, you can put it up. I mean, the guy did put it on that YouTube thing. His other thing. So I don't know if we can take it down.
Well, I mean, I don't.
The boys are hanging now. Obviously.
I'll let Brown Bear be our quality control.
How old is this kid? Should I? Is it safe for me to save this to my computer?
That's so funny. You got it.
No, shit. I'm serious. Okay, we do so, buddy.
That shit is funny.
You got me cracking up. All right, anyways.
That might be in our Patreon. We'll put the Patreon out, show the nutsack photo.
That's funny. You gotta stop. I can't host the show when you're cracking me off like that, man. let me just laugh it off. Someone else gotta grab the mic for a second. I mean, do you guys want to continue on the? I feel like the jerseys are bad.
We understand. Nah, we'll keep it moving. We'll keep it moving. We made our points. Yeah, jerseys suck. That was a huge off season thing. No, that is. We got to talk about it.
And then of course the Otani scale. I guess I'm just trying to get the two like kind of trashier things out of the way. But like, I mean, we like jerseys, dude. Fashion's not like trashy at all. But like,
yo, front and center on the retro TV. Let them know. Damn, honey, you might want to look away. Damn, let them know. Are those steroid balls? That's crazy.
How'd the photographer not just be bro, like, I'm gonna do you solid, bro. Like, adjust your shit.
Yeah, he's like, maybe let's take the stool away. You were gonna stand up for this, dude. Yeah, open leg on us. Crazy. Crazy.
You guys are cracking me up.
I wish we need a woman's perspective though, because maybe that's it. Maybe we're old school. Maybe that's, they're trying to get new fans, dude.
He's got the Riz, bro.
Yeah, that's Riz nowadays, dude.
You guys are cracking me up. I'm dying. So what are your hot I'm sorry, man. I'm just cracking up. All right, what are your your hot takes on Ipe and is that how you pronounce his name? Sorry,
I think
Ipe
so.
And Shohei.
Ipe or Ipe,
man, because like it was a big nothing burger. I feel like it's just like two homies translator, but like then you know, like it's not a nothing burger. It's just like you kind of knew Ipe, you know, because he like was part of Shohei's media, like present. He was just like in the dugout with him. Well, one, he was in the dugout with him. I feel like you would just see him at the games, right?
Yeah.
And then two, he would like translate for him, obviously. So like,
I think that's pretty common for the team to have the. I think it's pretty common for the team to have the interpreter in the dugout.
Yeah. No, I know, but was he there the whole time? That was he Shohei's interpreter the whole time?
As far as I know,
he's been in America.
Yeah.
Damn. Yeah, so, yeah, hit that. I mean, the recap on that is, like, probably not as cut and dry as, like, I feel like everybody agrees that. Well, not. It sounds like there's the counter argument that they're trying to go for the the moisture wicking or whatever. But, I mean, how do you feel about Ohtani? Like, I'm interested in just, like, the random sample of, like, we both know, I mean, I've said this on the phone a bunch with you guys already, but like, is he cool and let his friend borrow $4 million, or is he just a kingpin who has a gambling addiction and he just pawn it off on translator, which is so crazy. I mean, crazy, it doesn't sound that crazy actually, weirdly. What, or is something in the middle, I guess.
Brownbear, you want to go first? I'll go first. Yeah, I got a couple of takes on it. It's like, this one's mad interesting to me. I think this is such like gambling and sports is such an interesting topic. It affects every sport. If you would have asked me like right after it happened, I would have definitely had a different opinion than now. But yeah, I got two takes. One, let's say you know, just off surface level, it's like. The stats on let me just preface to where it was translator, but I don't know if you guys seem like it almost seemed like assistant slash like just you know like I don't know they were close like they're always together, so I don't know what the job description for a translator is because it kind of seemed like there was blurred lines on personal assistant type stuff too, just because the fact it's like they. I don't know. They're just with each other all the time. You would think if it's just a translator, there would be times when you're just chilling outside of baseball and he's not there with you, but they seem to be there all the time. So it's like homies, translator, maybe personal assistant. So then talking about the stats on just like how many celebrities and rich people actually have had cases of their, assistant, stealing money from them. And that was another article or something I've seen where it's like in the hundreds of just there's been a lot of times this has happened. So
okay,
that's not really a take. Just I just want to kind of put that out there of just being like you're hanging around with someone that has an absurd amount of money that you know handing the cookie jar doesn't seem too crazy. Now that's just you know right service level like now when you look at the actual things that happen, that's not exactly the case, but I think it's always interesting to put that out there, just being like kind of painting the frame of like, oh yeah, these things has happened of just money going missing, and it's not like the it's not like, oh, it doesn't really make like Shohei a monster, it doesn't really make like eBay a monster. But now my other kind of main take is just like the and I think this is what we're all going to talk about is just the chronological order it went down of just him saying he let him borrow it and then him having to retract it, because I kind of just think it's like I think the shit happened and then he was like I don't know, like maybe he's just like I'm just gonna let you, maybe he took the money, let's say there's that timeline where he took the money and then Shohei caught him and then he's like, well, I'm just gonna say I let you borrow it because like whatever, and then his team was like, no, 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 there's too much. This is going to be a crazy loss, so you have to say he stole it now. Or there's just the thing where they kind of knew of the betting and they were going back and forth. But I really think at the end of the day, I think, like, you know, I don't know the people, but it's like, I just think Shohei was naive. I think he just knew he had a gambling problem, and I think he just let him borrow the money, and then it was going to a legal bookie, which I don't know if he knew about, but I don't know. That's my take. I think it's a poor take. I'm interested in what you guys think. I think, honestly, the more I read about it, the more I'm just like, that's my gut feeling. I think, actually, it's probably not the best, like, you know, point of view on the whole situation. But this is also coming from, like, I'm a big Shohei fan, so, like, you know, if I'm the type of dude who's like, what's your opinion? I'm just like, well, I think Shohei's clean, and then it comes out that he actually is a gambling maniac, then I'd kind of be like, well, I probably had the blinders on, and I didn't see that. Yes, but it's also like, I've seen him hit the longest home run I've ever seen a person, so I don't give a fuck.
No, I feel like I agree with you mostly. I think you make an interesting point, or bring up an interesting point with the blurred lines thing. That's definitely a way that ePay could, you know, if we go down the road of, like, it was stolen, like the blurred lines and access to his life in, like, a way that a translator wouldn't traditionally have, I think is definitely a way that could have happened. But I feel like I agree with you that I think Shohei is who he seems like. I don't think he's got this big facade of being this, like, kind of dorky, charming dude that seems pretty innocent and pretty, like, naive. I feel like he is that way. And yeah, either for it to have been stolen, I feel like he's an idiot on two counts, because that means, like, he had $4 million go missing and, like, didn't immediately realize it, and then isn't communicating closely enough with his legal team, which would have been investigating this for, like, probably quite a while to figure out what happened. And, like, the day that it became public, they were, like, kicking it, seemingly on good terms, in the dugout in Korea for the Korea series. So, like, he's either, he's either oblivious on, like, two counts, where he just, like, totally didn't realize what was going on, isn't on top of his money enough to know, like, $4 million went missing, and then isn't connected enough with his lawyers for them to, like, tell him, like, hey, be, like, watch out for this dude who's, like, so close to you because he's stealing from you. So, to me, that all, like, isn't it as believable as him just being naive and helping out a homie and, like, paying something directly out of an account that, like, probably shouldn't have been paid that way. But then that kind of goes to what I'm saying.
Yeah, he didn't know it's a federal crime, man.
But I don't think he knew that he was doing anything wrong anyway, because I don't think he would have got, if he knew that
it was a federal crime. Yeah.
And I think if he knew that he was doing anything wrong by helping his friend, I don't think he would have gone to the lengths of, like, trying to obscure the payment. So I think that goes further into saying, like, it was just kind of like an innocent, naive, trying to help a friend thing, where he's like, yeah, I was just giving my homie money. Because I don't know, if he was being, like, weird and diabolical, then I feel like he would have tried to cover it up and, like, make some weird third party payment or something.
Yeah, you're right.
So, yeah, you can't cash that 4 milli, man. Well, boy should have got Bitcoin or something.
It's a weird story, because it's like, it did start with a federal investigation where they're, like, tracking somebody, and Ohtani's name came up in payments, and that's how the Donaghy NBA ref got caught with a true, you know, gambling scheme. But yeah, it's interesting about. I like both, you know, you guys seem like you're chilled out on it, because the internet makes it just seem like everybody's got, like, hard, fast opinions on it. But it's like, most people, I feel like, it's like, you don't really know Ohtani. He's just a celebrity baseball player. So it's like, I kind of could see all three being real. But then when he came out the press conference, I don't know, I was just like, all right. Maybe he did steal the money, and it's like, if he didn't, it's corny that it's even a law. Like, why is that a law? Why can't your friend help you pay gambling debt?
Yeah.
It's like an honorable thing to do.
That is interesting, because, like, when you get to, like, the press conference part about it, he does seem kind of, I mean, he doesn't really seem that angry, but like the things that he's interpreting, that he's being, things that are being interpreted that he said are like pretty harsh, where he's just like, homie was lying, he was stealing from me. So it, that just doesn't add up to me with like the timeline of him finding out about it, because he didn't seem pissed off like
Yeah.
that a week before at the guy. And for him to not have known about it at that point seems kind of wild. So that's where I start to think like the story got changed at some point because his legal team stepped in and was like, you're going to get in trouble unless you say he stole it.
Yeah, that's
And then
yeah,
that
and they're
opens
probably
other
just like,
avenues.
or sorry, my bad. Okay,
No,
go
no, no. I was just going to say
ahead.
that opens other avenues of like, what did they do to come up with this? But like,
Yeah.
how, like, did they have now? What are they? Are they paying off Ipe somehow to like let them totally trash this dude's name? Like,
Yeah.
because I mean, it looks bad enough on him regardless. But I feel like for it to be on the record of like, yeah, this dude stole from me, is potentially getting him in even more trouble for like, theft charges now rather than just like the gambling situation. So.
Yeah.
No, I totally agree too. And it's like, I think at first he probably was like, oh, this might just be an MLB investigation, like culturally and like public image wise, I'm just gonna, say the borrowing thing. And then I think once he saw the feds were knocking and his lawyers were like, yo, the feds have a giant
That's
case on this
good.
other bookie. Like, we do not want to be like, because like that, I think that's just the whole thing. It's like when they're trying to take down someone like that, they need, I feel like, probably high profile examples to,
Yeah.
lock that other dude up. But
He'll probably be on
interesting
the Mookie
culturally how
Betts
they attack
podcast and
the
stuff.
dudes
Yeah.
instead of the bookie guy, because it's like, but it's also my last point too is like, or I don't, sorry to cut you guys off, but like I watched the thing. I don't know if you've seen like, and not to jump or clump like coming up in baseball in Japan together, but there is that famous Ichiro quote that he talks about where he's like, when I trained to become a baseball player, he's like, I had 5 hours a year to hang out with friends. So he's like, the fact that it's like Ohtani would just suddenly get into like gambling after he's like, the things just don't really check out to me. It's like, why after?
No,
It just
that
is
part
like,
of the story is the
where?
most least likely to me, is that he is
Yeah,
that
it's
that
like,
he
how did he
personally has a
develop
big gambling
gambling
issue.
issues? Yeah.
He
But
like,
it's like when you see the comments, and obviously the comments are bullshit, but it's like, it's funny that that's where people jump to, just being like, yeah, get him out the sport.
well,
He's, it's like, it's so funny. I'm like,
yeah.
damn, this doesn't make any, that one doesn't really make any sense,
It
man.
definitely, whatever, even if it is, even if it's just Ipe, even if it's somehow maniacally the puppet master is what we'll call it, Shohei, it does kind of have like a weird, it puts something in his legacy as the 2000, 24 season pops off. But Brownmer, as the show started, you said MLB's kind of swept that under the rug now that the games have started, like now that the boys are back from Korea, which was a great series, by the way. I know it was like the times were weird and there was shit weird with it, but like Korea's definitely represented, and we've done the whole like all the leagues. We went on the world tour of leagues, and this big shout out to Korean leagues for sure. They got Swole Daddy, dude, right here. They got our boy. Real spit. Yeah,
Hell yeah.
that's our team
Yeah,
here on
there
the
you go.
baseball
Damn.
hippies. So we rock. We rock. We've been around the world with this baseball hippie shit, y'all. So we just
Awesome.
love y'all. And man,
Well,
that's
I do have one last,
yeah.
one last. This is
Okay.
sidebar, because that it would be
Sidebar.
fun to kind of tread through the YouTubes and videos to find this. But there is, now this is conspiracy theory, Tobe, smoking weed and shit, but like there is an avenue where I've seen, and I don't think Shohei's a bad guy, but I've definitely seen them where he kind of clowns on Ipe a lot, like during the times. I've seen him practically joke him. I've seen him kind of
They
like
have
him
like
being the
cut-ups
butt
on
of
YouTube.
jokes. So there would be funny if you could piece together this video where it's like every time
Well, man,
Shohei clowned on
again,
him and he's just like
yeah.
in the back of his mind, he's like, man, I'm about to steal hella money from this dude. Like, fuck
Yeah,
this
they like
guy,
zoom in
bro.
on his
He's like,
face and he's all like,
yeah. Like,
he's like, ah, you broke motherfucker. He's
yeah.
like, what? I'm your translator.
He's like, dude, no, yeah, so that could be another avenue where secretly he's like, man, he's like, this guy's clowning me
one too many times. Another thing is, he said he went to high school. Dude, there's a lot of weird stuff.
Oh, yeah, that part's interesting. Yeah, no, college, and dude, college degree. Yeah,
college. But I think like that kind of goes into, I forget who brought this up. It was in our group text, I think. But like, if they are trying to like, to shift the focus onto him having stole this, I think it makes it easier to believe that if you come up with some dirt about like, oh yeah, he's a liar. Cause like, it's easy to believe he's a thief if he's also a liar.
I get that you're saying he hooked him up and then had to retract cause it's a crime. But if you go with the dark side, the puppet master one, think about that. That one part is weird where he's like, he somehow gets a tip off before everyone cause he's mega rich. Like, hey man, they got your name on a federal list, and he just immediately is like, oh shit. And like, you know, you did say, man, he said he only had 5 hours to hang out with his friends growing up because he was so dedicated to baseball. Why would he have a gambling addiction? I'm like, because he never hung out with anybody ways. And he's a fucking multi-millionaire and he's got like 37 mil in escrow. Like, you know, he's like 10 years from now he's got like his untaxed 37 million. I'm not even making this up. In 10 years, right, on at this time in 2034, he's gonna get 37 mil that year, and then for 10 years he's gonna get another 37 mil every year. That's crazy.
Yeah, it's wild, man. And that's, yeah, we don't need to get all into his money, but he'll probably be a billionaire by then anyway with his endorsements. And
yeah, true.
So who knows? It is weird because it puts, like, unfortunately, if it's not him and it is, you know, Ipe, then, you know, it kind of opens up this weird thing. It's like, how much do we really know Otani? And weirdly, the right when he goes over to the Dodgers, his first off the field little thing, you know, it's like the new wave is in the air. And I think we're all excited to see Atlanta, LA face off. But let's talk about the beginning of the season, man. It's all started. Any surprises or disappointments this year besides – you know, the jerseys and Otani being a complete maniacal kingpin and gambling, like just 500. He was just like, yeah, that's a day of gambling, man. Are you kidding me? Like, I lost 500K. I make that back in a day, man. I got like different, but it's also weird because it's legal in 40 states, so it's also adds a weirdness, but we don't have to talk about it. All right, disappointments and surprises early, because you know how the first week of the season goes. It's not indicative of the summer times. Baseball's weird like that. Like, after the All-Star break, I feel like is when a lot of the realness starts of, like, who's really that dude. But anything out the gate, man, because sometimes people are just out the gate and never look back. That's also the case.
I'd say Yankees sweeping Houston, and Houston's an interesting one. Be something to watch.
That's
big. Man, I'm gonna buy Apple TV this year and try to catch those Friday night games. Their broadcast is on a different level, dude. I will give them that credit. Like, it's kind of makes baseball kind of a little fun. I kind of like it.
I love the Apple TV broadcast. I think they're like, they're polarizing. Some people hate them because they're like, they have weird,
like, they're
random
trying new shit.
I do too. And I'll argue that The camera work on the Apple TV games is top notch. It's like the best camera work in baseball.
There you go. The pitch sequence is so sick, dude. They show every pitch during an at bat sometimes.
Yeah, I feel like a lot of the hate they get is because of the color commentators they choose aren't always people's favorite. Oh, yeah. But I'm down when they do, like, I like when they do different things and have different perspectives and stuff. Yeah. And like, I don't need to hear some like 60-year-old white dude like talking about, you know, back in back in my day, we never took a step forward in the box. We always stayed back in the box, and it's not something I would do. I don't know. That was Mike Blowers was on one today about that, and it's like this is the weirdest line of questioning. Like,
Flowers.
and you know, Junior, he would take a step up in the box, and we would all just sit back and shake our heads and laugh.
Love it.
So anyway, my point
Flowers
is.
accepts, yes, yeah. He accepts some of the new game, though. He'll say, like, nowadays they do that, and that's just how the game is. But he
No,
doesn't seem like
I
he's
actually love
mad or
Blower.
anything. He'll be like, yeah, that's what they do now.
I love Blowers, but I do feel like he does a lot of the like, well, back in my day.
Yeah, he deaf. He deaf. He's been doing that probably for a long time, so now it just fits his character. He kind of gives me like you have been a dad for a long time vibes, because you like even before you were a dad, you were kind of had dad vibes. But man, Yankees beating okay with the Yankees real quick, man. Tobe, you drafted Soto. He was looking good in spring training, and like there's something about him in New York. Like I don't know, like he's kind of polarizing in his own way, but like I feel like he has to play for New York or LA now. Is that crazy? Because like he did the Padres thing, but like I feel like I guess what I'm trying to say is he should just re-sign with the Yankees, man. He like you could tell he feeds off that one type of energy, and with Yankees games, he'll get that energy every time. I feel like. Like they
Yeah,
respect all the little shit, and if he just checks in and does that, and it's not like what crazy, he'll be loved, you know. And then he obviously you have to be clutch, but like that was never really a problem for Soto. That wasn't his Achilles, you know.
no,
So.
I totally agree. I think I'm not, I'm not a Yankees fan, but boy, does he look good in the pinstripes, man. It's a legacy thing. It kind of just it makes sense, man. He's kind of, I don't know. Obviously, people give him their respect, but to me, his whole career is like, I don't know. People rate him high, but I'm still like, this is the dude, bro. In my opinion, I'm like, even with that Padres team last year, and people said that was a disaster because they had so many stars, like, he still put up a crazy year, and he's 24. It just doesn't, like, I just think the career he's building, if he does good in New York, like, he has the opportunity to go down as one of the best ever, especially with how he came up with the Nationals. Like, I'm a huge Soto fan. I think the Soto shuffle is so sick. I think the fact that it pisses off Verlander and all these like fucking funny ass Hall of Famer pitchers, I think it's so sick. And he always stands on business. Like, even when they go back and forth, he's never gonna rush the mound. He kind of just does his shit, tips his hat, and
Hey,
then
real
he
quick,
hit a
real
home
quick.
run off
This,
that Verlander shit
yeah,
too. So.
Tub, real quick. The shuffle is going to be interesting with the new jerseys this year. Let's just say that. But hey, man, I know you're a Yankees fan and you love Soto, so you got that off, you got that off. But anything else though, man? Because I guess what I'll say is, I think the Orioles are a real team to watch, man. Like, I don't know, man. Something is weird there. I just feel like they're kind of in the Mariners territory with like no offense to us because we're huge Mariners fans, like less delusion in the weird way, because like they just if they don't get a World Series in their little tenure here, I will be surprised. And I can't just say that about any team, but it like there's something about like again I know I go back I'm like Blowers that goes back to the Royals and stuff, but like teams like that are beloved because it's like they got like a weird core and they were weak, and like that little combination's good. And even Houston had a little bit of that, even though we kind of didn't like them. Then the cheating scandal happened, but like, yeah, it just seems like they're getting tighter. And then like, yeah, Webb's good pickup, and like, I'll just say, man, like I hated on Robbie Ray a lot, but something about the early season that I got, because I think I got Eovaldi and. Bieber coming off an injury on my fantasy is like I talk shit on Robbie Ray, but the pitchers who have won Cy Youngs and even have had off years are actually pretty fucking good. It's just weird, like, how pitching works. You can just get little adjustments or whatever the fuck, because, like, Snell is, like, in that category, but you know who I talk shit on a lot? Cole. Because he was weak at the end of his Pirates tenure, and then he, like, changed it up a little bit, but, like, I think it's, like, you definitely go through those eras, and it probably has to do with pitch sequence, but and how you're throwing your stuff. But man, like, all these notable dudes are still killing it, and I'm just kind of like, it surprises me, because even like, I don't know why it surprises me, but it's just like, starting pitching is hard to me, I guess what I'm trying to say.
Yeah,
there's been a lot of surprising starters is where I'm at. Yeah, that's where I'm at.
Talking about the Orioles real quick, it's not really a surprise to me if they're good, but I do look at them a lot like the Mariners, but kind of the opposite. We have the development of pitchers figured out. Yeah. They have the development of hitters figured out. They do have some good pitchers come up through their organization, but they really have hit on a number of hitting prospects. And then I feel like they have added where they need to. Like, you kept saying Webb. I think you mean Corbin Burns.
Yeah, Burns.
I'm sorry. Yeah. I keep thinking Logan Webb.
It's all good. Yeah.
Was a great pickup from Milwaukee. Yeah.
But yeah, so doing things like that. And part of that is they just switched ownership, which is huge for them. Like, I think we all saw the video of the owner like buying everyone a beer on opening day. I'm just like, the vibes are immaculate in Baltimore.
Vibes are top notch. Yeah, top notch.
Yeah. We can't go. Yeah, dude. And they were good with the old owner. It's just weird. Like, he has a checkered past. You know, like, he was beloved, RIP, but also.
Yeah, but then I think his son was like running things and not doing a great job, from my understanding, or not investing money in a good way. But I think what I'm getting at with the new owner thing is like, hopefully they'll be able to add in ways that maybe we would hope the Mariners would do to get to that next level or to sustain where they're at, you know? Anyway, I like the Orioles. They're a fun team.
Yeah, they're a fun team. Orioles. They got dudes.
Mariners, Orioles connect. We rock with the Birds because, like, it's just all about the underdog story. I've realized when it comes to baseball teams I root for, I would never root for the big dog, like, come around, the bully. It's always the bully, but when the bullied become the bully, that's when baseball time shift, man, like, there's always like teams that just get beat up by the same teams every year, including the Mariners. But like every time, one year, they just come back and then they just go and become you can't get beat them. So it'll be interesting with our division this year. I think we like came out the gate pretty much exactly how we did last year, which kind of bothers me. Just good at some things, bad at other things, mediocre overall, you know, and then like could go on a hot streak. But I just real quickly have to say, because I looked at the standings and I know they were talking about this on one of the other pods, but what's up with the Tigers, man? Another underdog. Are they for real at all? Or is like, this is way early? Do we know anything about the Tigers? Again, they got
helps when like half your games get rained out for the first month of the season because you for some reason build a stadium in Detroit without a roof on it. But
yeah, that is insane.
Well, they're 1,000%. Their 1,000 winning percentage would say different, but yes, they play 4 games, and we played 6.
7.
You're right.
Tyreek Skubal. We played Skubal, dude. Right.
No, they got some interesting players, and I feel like a couple years ago, everyone was on the lookout for like the next wave of Detroit, but I don't know what happened there. I feel like they made some weird moves. Like, I don't know if like there's that big shortstop class a couple years ago, and they went with Javi Baez out of all like the shortstops to sign. Ooh. And like, I feel like that was a miss.
Yeah, that was a wild one.
He's not been great. I don't know how you do. I mean, like,
man, I think they got real. Yeah.
The only thing, other thing I was going to say is they got tied up in Miguel Cabrera, though. They were, the era where they gave that money to Miguel Cabrera was that you did that kind of thing. Like, you made those kind of extensions on older players, but like,
yeah.
Shout out Miggy, but it's hard to be stuck paying that kind of money to that dude for the back half of their career and try to build like the next wave of your team.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, that's true. I mean, he's a legend in his own right, but yeah, I mean, I just got to say out loud, Javi Baez would definitely be on the list for Baseball Hippie if he was in the spotlight more. I think he just gets overshined because he's not on a good team, but he does have the MLB logo tatted on his neck. And his nickname is El Mango.
El Mago.
El Mago.
El Mago. He's the magician. Yeah.
So he has, man. I was going to say it out loud too, since we're talking about little underdog teams. I'm just getting all reminiscent because we're back. We're back. Breaking up the Chicago Cubs is like the saddest thing ever. Like Schwarbs, Chris Bryant, Baez, and like the, like maybe another guy, you know, because.
Hey, Belly?
Yeah.
Rizzo.
I mean, I'm.
Rizzo.
Rizzo, yep. Exactly.
Bellinger.
And just like it. Yeah, they could have, like, you know, a little rotating cast because they had, what's his name, who's Josh loves to, what's this guy's name? He quit baseball because his country singer wife cheated on his their pastor, Josh. Josh Jacob Jingleheimer Schmidt loves this straight-up story of Ben Zobrist. Shout outs, man.
Zobrist.
Anyway,
shout out that Cubs team that won it. But yeah, man. Good little first part of the season. We'll probably run predictions next show. Yeah, man. Anything crazy that needs to be discussed? I mean, I know last show, I definitely remember us feeling like whatever happens, we're cool with it.
Mariners wise?
We were killing. And then we were like, man, who knows what this last week. It was like the craziest thing where like we missed the playoffs by a game. Then we beat the Rangers for the last game of the season when it didn't matter. So they didn't win the division. So now Houston wins the division and they have to play in the wild card. And then they just go on. Okay, wait, before they do this, then Cal Raleigh, big dumper, in the locker room, the last game of the season, just happens to say, yeah, it would have been nice if we just would have got like one more guy, just kind of like the Rangers got Semien and Seager and just paid like 200 mil or whatever. And then they just go on to win the World Series right after he said that. Yeah. Then Jerry DePoto comes out and says,
and they said Bochy gave a speech after they lost that game that basically hyped them up to make a playoff run too, in the Mariners clubhouse, in the away clubhouse. So, yeah.
Footnote.
Sorry. Yeah.
You're fine. No, that's good. That needs to be mentioned. That dust is in the Mariners away locker room. The same goes seeing some wild games. That 18, our last playoff game was 18 innings, and then we lost that. So they went on to win that series. But I guess what I'm saying is, then DePoto comes out with the 54% quote, right? And then he's like, yeah, we're just trying to win 54% of the games. And I know that's not in context, everybody. But I'm just saying, that's like an average Joe. That's how I like kind of. I'm just on the street reporting, man. That's what the baseball hippie shows.
No, I feel you. That didn't piss me off as much as it did a lot of people, but I see why like casual fans hear that and they get real mad. Like, I get why people are mad about it.
I mean, I like it. I'm like trying to get more into Sabermetrics and stuff, and like,
whatever, man. I don't know what percentile it is, but whatever percentage we got to win to get into the playoffs, then win a World Series, I don't give a shit what they call
He's
it.
He's also trying
I call it 93 games. 94, maybe.
Yeah, he's trying to... Yeah, I don't know. I feel like Jerry's in a tough spot. Trying to work with an ownership group that's notoriously look. I don't want to hate on them too. I don't really. It bothers me when people just like shit all over what you have. Like we have what we have. We can't change it. It's not like we're gonna go in and like all pitch in and buy the team and become the owners. Like you have what you have. Do you like the Mariners or not? Are you gonna follow the Mariners or not? That's where I'm at with it. But I will say like I get it. Like we have an ownership group that notoriously, in particular, over the last. Since the Cano contract, basically, don't really like to invest money. Although you look at shit like that and you're like, oh, they got burned on a dude who they invested 200 mil in and did a bunch of fucking steroids and got suspended. So I get why maybe you don't want to go throw a bunch of money at rock stars anymore. My point being, let me backtrack a little bit, is that notoriously don't like to spend money. Also comes out that we have this wild ass fucking cable contract thing. Not go our way and like not to even mention that they invested a ton of money in the Blazers and the Kraken and stuff and trying to have their own sports network. Like DePoto's in a tough spot of trying to make it work, and I think he like tried to do his DePoto thing, and then he also notoriously has like a weird fucking sense of humor, so I feel like the 54% thing was like I feel like he's being earnest, but I also think he's trying to be a little cheeky. And it just didn't come across right at all. Like people didn't get the like. It's also it's like something you probably shouldn't be joking about when we miss the playoffs. But also then like, no one got that it was supposed to be a joke and thought he was like dead serious about it. Which I don't know. It just it was taken the worst possible way, and I feel
it was
like,
at a bad time too.
It was. Yeah, I'm like, not trying to defend him for saying it. Really, just feel like.
And then he got rid of a fan favorite player next. And then it all kind of like, I was just going to get it, like, it just waved out. And then, like, when we got back to the beginning of the season, I didn't feel like everybody was that mad. We were, people were pretty high on, like, okay, we got a few pieces and we got some good pitcher. You know, we still have our good starters. We didn't do anything crazy with them. But, man, footnote is Cano's agent was literally Jay-Z for that deal. So we got to mention that.
And, dude, DePoto hit them. Wait, my bad. Sorry.
I kind of forgot the other footnote, but man. Oh, yeah. The other footnote is Brute Sports, man, is like, so this new shit, like this is, we got to get to the times where MLB owns the local games. I would love that myself. They're like talking about like claiming bankruptcy and Arizona owns them. I'm like, damn. Then my T-Mobile account would pay for my MLB so I could watch this shit. Because, like, I literally tried to sign up for Fubo. And it wouldn't take my credit card information. I looked it up online and people were like, yeah, man, this happens to, like, a lot of people. Like, their customer service is shit.
Fubo is the wackest shit ever. I get Fubo through... Like,
I was looking up Comcast and like how to get cable TV again just to watch the Mariners another $100 a month. And I was like, damn, bro, this is such a fucking hassle. I might just like illegally stream, allegedly, but you know what I'm saying? Like, I was just like, damn, bro, this is how people get driven to the black market. Like, for real. Like, I'm just like you said, though, I'm just trying to be a Mariners fan. They don't make it easy, though.
No, they don't. They don't. And I have Fubo. Me and my dad share a Fubo. And
that's a good idea.
I will say.
That's the move. Yeah.
It's good. But I will say they know that they provide access to something that you can't access any other way rather except for paying higher prices at cable or illegally streaming it. And I think because they know that, like the Fubo product is one of the worst apps I've ever fucking used. It's god awful. Exactly. It functions
they know
so
once that
poorly.
Contract goes through,
they just don't
just
give a fuck.
Dude.
The user interface is awful. It's you know like every other thing I've used that like records something for you, like a TiVo, like YouTube TV, satellite TV, that like records things. It's pretty like intuitive how to use it and like navigate through it and fast forward and rewind. I swear, every time I'm trying to like rewind or pause Fubo, I act like close the entire fucking app somehow and lose what I'm watching. It's just like,
Yeah, they don't have the
dude, it's
app on
crazy.
your
Well,
PS
it's
either,
glitchy
so it's
now
not
too. I
really
mean,
on that shit. Yeah.
it gets
Yours
glitchy
glitching?
now. About what?
Mine's,
dude, mine glitches out all the
yeah.
time.
I looked it up. It's been glitching. But see, now this is. See, now I totally agree with you. I think it's. Whatever. But they're doing an interesting thing, which I don't have all the deets on. But maybe we should talk about it next episode about kind of tap into it a little bit. But basically, Fubo is suing. They're suing Disney. They're suing Fox. They're suing Warner Bros. Because what's happening is they. And now, obviously, I'm talking on my ass. I don't know all the deets, but it's like. Besides, obviously, your like Root Sports, your local sports stations for all the different regions and shit. So they were trying to come out. Obviously, we saw the commercials back in the day. We're like, we're gonna be sports first, just a sports package. It's gonna be cheaper. You can watch national sports and you can watch your local. And basically, what those three main cable companies did, they were like, well, we actually have the rights in front of these, like Roots for example, and then. Comparatively to like the Yankees who own their own sports channel, which is like YES Network, so it all comes back to them. But for other ones they own, they were like, no. You can't just buy sports networks. You have to buy the entire cable package. So they ran it for 2 years and then they're like, no, you can do this. Now when you buy Fubo, it comes with all these different channels. So then they shot up their prices. Now it's $100 a month. So what Fubo now has this long-standing suit where they're suing them, being like, we just want to buy the sports networks and drop our prices down. Now, the truth, who the fuck knows? It's somewhere in between. I don't
This
know
would
if
be a
Fubo's
good
just trying to
business
do this
model.
as
You
like
could
a
take a
pop
shitty
culture
app
thing
and
and
just
like
cheat.
that's what I'm saying. I don't know if Fubo's just taking this route of being like, oh, we're the small guy standing up to a big cable company. But I think there's, somewhere in between where there's truth of just I think it's two corporations. And it definitely, just seeing how, Disney and Fox and all those were thrown by Viacom. It's like how they strong arm this stuff and, just ranting of being like, well, when we were kids, you could just throw on, local TV and it would be on, sports would be on a thing, which we're obviously far removed from. But I think it's weird. Like, I just think Fubo, besides getting Root, which is even more expensive, is now our best option. And it's like interesting because now, especially this year, it's been glitchy. And I think whatever's going on with their servers or their cable towers or well, I don't know, they're not getting maintenance or something. I don't know. But I'm just like, things are
All your
headed, I
money's
don't know.
going into this lawsuit.
I just
Nah,
wish
man,
there
it's
was a way I
crazy.
could give
Yeah,
the team money to watch the game. Like, let me just, like, we
right.
own Root. Just let me stream, give me a streaming app for Root and I'll give you money.
Yeah.
That's all I want.
Yeah,
Just, yeah.
exactly.
Yeah, exactly.
Same,
Exactly.
same. No fluff. And honestly, it doesn't even have to have channels and like extra shit. Like,
No,
if
I
it was
want one
just
channel.
2 hour
I
games,
want
I'm paying
Root.
20 a month, bro.
Yeah.
Well,
And it's goddamn phone bill, like
I think that's what the
$100.
bigger market. I think that's what the Yankees do. Like, yes, from what my knowledge is, you can for YES Network. Like, the Yankees own all of YES Network, and you can just get the Yankees channel, or and it's like an app too. But I might be wrong about that. Don't quote me on that.
Yeah, well,
But I don't know. It's still
either way,
probably
something's
expensive.
got to give. Something's got to give, man. And Stanek really brings it all together, dude. It's like,
Wait,
he's just
I had a
fucking.
joke before we move on about the DePoto 54%. DePoto's the type of dude who it's like makes his cousin cry at a dinner party of being like, listen, like only 54% of marriages don't end up in divorce. So just because Bill left, yeah, it's okay. You'll find another one. And then she cries and leaves. And it's like, Jerry, why'd you have to say that, man? He's like, I don't know, dude. I don't know. I
Came
thought I was a
out.
helper.
Just
It's
came
like, the numbers don't help, man. The numbers sometimes don't help, dude.
out.
A personal
Kind
thing,
of
but yeah.
reminds me of that dude on Parks and Recs with the gelled hair. He's like, who is that?
Rob Lowe's
DePoto's
character?
got it. Yeah, Rob Lowe. He's
Oh,
got star power to him,
yeah.
He's all like, he's like, yeah,
Damn.
I'm, yeah,
That's pretty
but like,
good.
he's chill.
That's really good. Have you seen him? Dude, that's so funny. He literally just has a new interview where he's talking about getting into cooking, and it's, yeah, it's exactly like Rob Lowe's character talking about it. It's insane. Yeah, it's just a really interesting thing to do, a new hobby with the family on Sundays. And it's like kind of talks like that. And I'm just like, well, it's like a robot learning how to cook, dude. It's so weird.
I got to start listening to his pod. He's like, he's got his little propaganda radio.
Like, King Five, King Five had an interview with Stanek and him, and he'll do his pod.
Yeah, he'll do his pod. And it, really, are you?
Yeah,
real?
You should watch it. Stanton. Yeah. Not, just thinking about this guy.
Oh yeah. Stanton. No, that's pretty, not interesting to me at all. But like,
it's you're gonna guess all their answers. But
it was a fluff piece for sure. They didn't like press him on anything.
For sure.
It's
he's like,
though,
Cal, I took him to my office after that, and I said, you're saying what I'm saying, bro. I was like, dude.
Oh, yeah, I did see that.
He's like, Cal, man, we got to do something about this ownership. He's like, Cal, just like, what?
There's like Instagram podcast people, and they're like, have a dude on there who's like, who says this? Who freaking says this? And I'm like, sitting there just like,
oh, I seen that guy, yeah. He definitely took a couple quotes out of context with the he's like, we could have signed Juan Soto. He says 200 mil is a throw in. I'm like, oh, yeah, I totally agree with you, but he was talking about signing like a 30-year-old dude, not Juan Soto. It's a little different, but yeah. He's like, bro, the guy says he doesn't want to give 200 to Juan Soto, man. He's like, that's crazy. It's like the quote was him talking about Corey Seager. He's like, I don't know, he could have Corey Seager. But it's like, either one's wrong. It's like Corey Seager's a HOFer, man. You know?
I don't think Corey Seager wanted to come got the here. Money his either, brother was yeah, here. His yeah. brother did not get
and,
along
and
with
and Juan Soto for sure didn't want to come here. I can take you to the bank on that one. For sure.
I promise like you that. Kyle Seager was telling Corey Seager, like, don't even talk to these dudes. Like, you do not want to fucking come here.
For sure. For sure. For sure.
All right, well, man, before we wrap this up, Tobe, you got to tell that story about Scotty, sir.
Oh, yeah.
Before you tell it, Scotty has gone up in my book, everybody. I'm like a dude who used to talk a lot of shit on him. But I think with new year comes new bygones. I feel like our vibe is very like, we just sit back, watch the games, listen. But man, this year so far has been kind of off the rails the way we describe it. But we don't love it any less, man. Shout out to Scotty, though. I'm glad you hit him with the story because it warms my heart.
Yeah, man. Brownbear, if you don't mind, could you go to that picture that I sent in Discord and get a zoom in on that face? Because that face, that angle, the angle is just amazing, dude.
On the Scott service one?
Yeah, there's one with Scott and Jerry standing and they're both smiling. Like,
yeah,
kind of
I couldn't get it pulled up because it's the format. It doesn't work.
Oh, it's like a web image. Yeah. Okay, it's all good. No worries.
But
let me
see what I can do.
Yeah, no worries. Yeah, so, we went to strength training this year. Super fun. First day in, go to the Mariners Stadium. It's like a Colorado and Mariners share the stadium. Go in, come early before the game. So for all the listeners out there, it's like they got the main – there's, you know, just obviously a bunch of stadiums all around outside of Phoenix. They got one kind of like a minor league type of field stadium, but then all around the stadiums, and it's all the same at every single facility. There's like five practice fields. So when you walk up – and all the practice fields kind of just look like high school just fields. So when we walked up, I was like – saw people playing on the practice fields. I was like, whoa, I wonder who's – because in my mind I'm like, there's no way like this the dudes could be playing on these fields, just the people walking around. So we get closer, and then when we just realize, we're like, oh damn, these are just the dudes who aren't playing. Oh yeah, there we go, thank you. Oh my god, that angle, holy
this
crap,
looked like
dude.
Two this
Look at that chin, dude. God damn, man. Oh, look at how high his glass. That's just insane. But yeah, so.
This is us right now, man. Keep going.
Dude, for real. Look at those catchers wearing the catcher's mask or something. He just like scrunched his face, fuckers. Insane. Sorry, I love Scott too. I'm trying to talk shit, but I'm like, what's good with his hat? Why is the logo is so tiny on his hat, dude? It like fits his face. It's so he's got the little league logo, the tiny logo. But
love
yeah, so we walk up, and I'm like, and we're tired. I mean, it's probably like 10 a.m. We walk up, we're seeing dudes crank ball. That's our first. We're like, ah, dudes are hitting balls, doing some BP, outfielders catching balls. So we're like trying to see, we're like, oh, maybe we know these people, minor leaguers. We like go through, there's like people kind of waiting behind the fence, but mind you, it's early. We're like our first day in. So we like take a right. We're like, all right, let's watch these dudes hit the ball. So the first right we take, we're 5 minutes into the thing, walking in these things, tired. First right we take, we just see Scott walking like basically towards us. And then we all kind of like stop. We're like, whoa, like is that Scott Service? And then there's a couple old couple kind of holding onto the fence looking, and then we can kind of overhear what he says. He goes, he has kind of a funny accent too. I don't know where he's from, but he goes, hey, he's like, would y'all believe me if I told you that's the next Yordan Alvarez? And he points to this dude in the outfield who's just giant, but he's like so far away. And we're like, whoa, yep. And then also in my head, I'm like, oh, okay, he's just like saying that, like gonna go walk back. And then says that, they chuckle, and then just like is walking kind of like more towards us because we're at the edge. We're at like the most corner left field exit type of thing. Walks to the fence, and we're like, whoa, like, is he about to say something to us? But then we didn't realize is there's a gate there. So he opens the gate. There's just him solo dolo. I mean, we're like probably an hour and a half away from the gate. I'm like, what the hell is going on? Opens the gate, bro. We're 4 feet away from him. Dude. If I could tell you, man, froze, dude. All we was with four, three different people. We just froze, bro. Eye contact, everything. Easily could have said what up. Easily probably could have done a dap at that point, dude. He looked chill as all hell. Great mood, had his little smile on. I was like, and damn, dude, for the Hippy baseball show nation, man, I froze. Oh God, and I feel
I
bad.
didn't
Yeah,
know that. Whoa, because a
it's
twist,
horrible,
man. I
dude.
didn't know that.
Horrible,
you didn't
bro. And
say
then he
that
just
when you first
kind of
told me this story.
smiled, and then just like walked away, and we all just turned to each other. We're like, "The sky." And then we're like, "Yeah." I was like, "Damn, dude, we could have just said what up." And then as he started walking, then hella people just started following him and shit. And we're like, "Damn, dude, I easily could have just got a dap, just a knuckle, just a good knucks to start the season." And it's all good. But I will say in person, bro, it's really funny, like seeing, I mean, you guys have probably experienced when you see like someone you see on TV all the time really close to you, and he's just like he's just a funny looking dude, man.
Big Scotty.
That's
Well, we
funny.
wish him the best this year and last year.
Yeah,
He's from
anticlimactic story.
Wisconsin,
Sorry.
by the way.
Okay, there we go. Yeah, there we go.
Well, that Yordan
Oh, actually, I
Alvarez
did know that because
lives
there's that hella
in
funny
Double
Green
A, right?
Bay Packers. He had a full Green Bay Packers suit on. There's a picture of it.
Okay.
For his boys, yeah, just drinking Miller Lite.
Dude, what you are on the what are you on amateur all day? Motherfucker, you're on Tobe's got like a media archive, man.
Yeah, that story reminds me when I was
Social
like
media extraordinary, dude.
I had a similar
Not really
experience
3 hours
on social media. You're like, I got a picture for everything, man. I'm social media meme queen.
The freeze is real, dude. I had the same experience when I was like 17 in New York. I saw the dude from Third Rock from the Sun, John Lithgow. And I just like same deal. I just like froze on the street and couldn't see and couldn't say anything.
So funny. It's so funny. That is good.
Wait,
That is
which
so
dude
good.
from Third Rock though?
The John Lithgow. I mean, he's from like way more than just Third Rock, but to
Oh
me, like that's what
yeah.
at the time
Oh,
I
yeah.
was.
Boy,
I was
that's the
17.
boy
That's what I knew
wanted
him
to
from
do
at the
Third Rock.
time.
Damn.
That's
Is he all
hilarious.
right? I think one of those guys passed.
Nah, he's alive.
Damn.
Dude, then for like the next couple hours, you're just like, dude, I could have said this. Like, could have cracked a chicken.
No way. No way.
Now he was like, I was walking down the street with my uncle, and he like walked across us to get like into a car, and like, he like walked right in front of us, and I like knew who he was, and I just like was standing there like an idiot. I could have been like, yo, what up, dude?
Yeah. But, you know, I always knew him, man. Third Rock from the Sun, he was good, but I always knew him as the evil dude in Cliffhanger.
Oh, he
was yeah. So fucking evil.
Damn, good call.
I don't think I'd seen Cliffhanger at that point.
Oh, it's fine. True, oh, okay. Yeah.
Yeah. He's so, yeah, he's good in that.
He was in Pet Cemetery, too. He's been in some 80s. Damn, so yeah. Anyways.
You know, wait, you know who doesn't freeze, though, when he sees funny people? We got to bring him on and talk about this. The oldest bro, Big J Cali, has really funny stories of just yelling at celebrities, and it just doesn't really go well. So that's the other one. He has a funny one of seeing Justin Bieber just yelling at him, and he just fucking he said he looked a little mad.
Then, my only two are as I saw Nate Robb at a gas station, and I just pulled up, and he was like buying something, and I was walked around the corner. I was like, Nate Robb? And he's like, what's up, man? And then I just like walked away. I see Sean Kemp at his weed store like a lot. Like I've seen him twice there. And one time I was like, Sean, and he was like so tall, and he was like, what up, dude? And he dabbed me and he gave me like a hug. And then he's like, you want a picture, man? And I was like, nah, man, I'm just here in the bus.
He probably respects that.
Man, I was just here to buy some weed.
He said, probably respected that.
Like, nah, he's like, weed.
He was, man. Shout out to Legends, but man, that is so funny. Yeah, man. I mean, we're you guys are cracking me off this man. Good fun times, and you know, in the true baseball hippie spirit, man. Like with the story we've told so far, you would have thought baseball is just like literally ripping at the seams, but. I don't know, man. Like, it's just, I think, like, the more I learn, like, because I do want to try to, like, learn more about the last decades, like, the last century. There's some holes, because, like, I met up with, I watched the opening day with our old, like, uncle friend who's, like, as old as my dad that me and Tobe grew up with, and he knows a lot about, like, 60s and 70s baseball, and he was a huge Reds fan. But he lived in New Jersey where everybody was Yankees fans, and like he just hates the Yankees so much. And like I realized that like some people hate team, like part of the fandom is how low they are of the evil. And I'm like feeling some transition because my team's so bad where I'm just like, yeah, I don't really like. I mean, I don't. I'm just different. Like I don't know, Brownbear, you don't, I don't know. There's some
teams. He's also ex-hippie, dude. So you got to realize that day and age, the Yankees represented the machine, dude. Cut your hair, yeah. Shave your beard, yeah. Bro. So, like, back in the 70s, and Yankees were like, yeah.
Yeah. And, like, he was telling me something. I just want to point this out real quick because it kind of took me by surprise. But he was a huge baseball fan since he was, like, 18. So he lived through the draft, was inducted in 1965, and he said before the draft, like, he in his opinion, like, the Yankees would just be self-serving way of drafting players is there was no restrictions, so they could just go to any player in the country or out of the country and be like, yo, you should come play for the Yankees. And since they were the Yankees, it was like easy for them to do that, you know. Mm-hmm. And so it's like, it's interesting that like to me, like, the corporatization in the 70s and 80s and then the draft of the 60s and the change from after World War II is, like, all an amazing time in baseball. And so our place in that now is our jerseys are falling apart because of the bad business deals and, like, gambling that's, like, kind of pseudo-legal. And I just love it because it's like, well, follow the line, man. It's like, this is where it leads, you know, like, this is where we are today. It's kind of like
baseball mimics history, man. Like, that's why it's one of the things people love about it. It's what I love about it.
Yeah. And like, this is gonna be this election year, so you know, it's gonna always have its own little thing. But like, man, I think we got a good season. I think we're in for some good vibes, weirdly. It's just like a static vibe because of the Ohtani to me. Again, it's just vibes. For me, but
Otani let like a
We're big
gust.
on vibes,
He was in Korea and he let like we were just like he let a bomb off when like his name came up in a federal and you know we were just like what and everybody's like fucking get on their first 48 like oh you see him lapping in the dugout like all the like you were just following it like that meme of Charlie from Always Sunny just you know pulling things together but in the end man it left a dust of like you know jacked up energy but baseball 162 man I'll see you at the you know it's a marathon so you know we've all know because we've done this for 5 years man what happens you know what happens in a season so we'll catch you guys all thanks for listening everybody and we'll catch you shit next time maybe next week but probably just whenever we can man and that's the Baseball Hippie Show, a show about baseball psychedelia denuclearization. You guys got anything to say?
Nah, it was fun.
Peace out.
Let's do it again soon.
Yes. Yeah. Super fun. Glad to be back, man. Good to spend some time with you guys.
We'll do predictions. We'll do predictions next time.
Yeah, we usually back in the day, we play a lot of that MLB The Show. Maybe we'll have to bring that back when they drop the price on that damn ditty. Good shit, guys. Always love talking baseball. Much love, everybody.
Yeah.